for corporate transformation. The moment we talk about leadership, we are talking about a vision. We are talking about a future. Leadership has three essential elements. First, the person who claims to be holding the leadership position should be able to handle the future, should be able to prepare a plan, should be able to prepare a vision document, should be able to prepare a guideline how the company is going to take the future course of action. Second, the person who is holding the leadership position should be able to display his conduct, his behavior, his personality, which others can admire and follow. And third, the person should take care of transformation of the entire team for the development and for the ultimate objectives to be achieved. Leadership is a very challenging assignment. Every organization, every society, every nation needs very good leaders so that they can develop. A very important activity for leader is development of its team members. Training and development is essential. It is not an option, it is essential. The first step is training need assessment. The training need assessment is carried out from two perspectives, external and internal. When we talk about external perspective for training need assessment, we are looking at perspective of the customers, perspective of the society, perspectives of the nation, perspectives of various stakeholders, and identify the gap, what they expect and what we are able to deliver. This gap has to be identified and training programs have to be designed to bridge the gap. Internal training need assessment is another tool wherein the leader tries to assess the training need, the training gap, based on internal resources by interacting with customers, by interacting with employees, by interacting with those people who are either members of the board of directors or members of the various committees in the organization. And they identify a gap, what is expected and what is actual performance. Any gap between expected and actual performance will create a need for training. So once we are able to identify a training need, there is the next step. The training programs have to be designed and implemented. Training programs must be participative, wherein every employee is fully involved. So every training program must have four essential components. It should be participative, it should involve people who are going to learn in the training program. Second, every training program should be such design that it is able to transmit those skills which are going to be useful in the corporate real life situation. The skills should be really applicable. If someone learns today and is not able to apply that thing in real life, there is no point. We have to impart those skills which are to be applied on day-to-day basis in real life so that people can see how these skills are useful. Third, the training programs should be such which ultimately generate greater revenues for the group, greater revenues for the organization, greater revenues for the individuals who are participating, because training involves commitment of resources. There is a time, there is a resources, money, which are required to be invested in training programs, and these resources have to be recapped by the society. There is a certain requirement in terms of returns from investment. Fourth, the training programs should be constantly monitored based on the feedback of the participants, based on the feedback from the society, based on feedback from other stakeholders. And ultimately, these training programs should enable the organization to serve the society. Training programs should help transformation of the employees so that they meet the expectations of the society. Every organization is there to serve a society. The needs of the society are most important. Organization stays to fulfill those needs. If the organization cannot fulfill the needs of the society, what's the need of having an organization? So, training and development is one essential aspect. Leadership plays the most important role. Leaders have to give stress on training, development. The training programs have to be properly designed and implemented, and they should be such which brings good results, results in the form of improved performance of the employees. After the training program, the employee should exhibit better performance. This is how the organization can slowly transform itself. The ultimate goal is that the organization should be able to serve the society. The society, which is the target beneficiary of the organization, should say that this is a great organization. If the society is fully satisfied, the organization is able to achieve its goal. That is the ultimate aim.